Let us now start the session with prayer song.
வரல செல்ஃப் நிக்குங்க இந்த ஆடியோ தான் கேக்குது
many enthusiastic participants. That's a pleasing welcome to what I know is going to be a great webinar. I would like to invite Ms. M. Renuka, Assistant Professor, Department of Biochemistry, to deliver the welcome address. Please, ma'am.
Thank you. Small cheers and great welcome, mates. Small cheers and great welcome, mates. Enthusiastic. Happy morning to all of you. On behalf of Madhur Kesari Jain College for Women, One in Body, I welcome you all for this 2 days international webinar on recent trends in recent advances in life sciences. On behalf of PG and Research Department of Biotechnology and Biochemistry, it's my privilege in welcoming our resource person, Dr. Prithviraj Nagaraj, Research Scientist, Arbade Medical College and Hospital, Puducherry, and Dr. A. Sai Ramesh, Assistant Professor, Department of Biotechnology, Veltech Hi-Tech, Dr. Rangarajan, Dr. Shakuntala Engineering College, Chennai. I welcome you and thank you, sir, for your great support and being with us to share our knowledge. I also extend my warm welcome to our secretary, Sri C. Lignichan G. Jain, and other trust members in absentia. I am pleased to welcome our principal, Dr. T. Balasubramanian. Welcome you, sir. We are fortunate to have the supporting professors and colleague participants from various institutions. Your strong support and active participation will make this international webinar a successful one. Pleasure in welcoming all around participants for this session from around the region. I am delighted in welcoming PRO Madam and organizing heads Dr. Komati and Ms. R. Malarkodi, who are the one who created this platform for all of us, which aims researchers in their area to explore their ideas in various ways. And heads of the department and faculties, welcome you all. I sincerely hope all these 2 days webinar and our guests will help you and guide you to promote your research works. Enjoy today's sessions. Welcome you all once again. Thank you.
Optimism field that leads to achievement. Now I repeat, our dynamic principal, Dr. T. Balasubramanian, sir, to give away the presentation address. Please, sir.
Honorable Management Trustees, distinguished Chief Guest, Dr. Prithviraj Nagarajan, Research Scientist, Multidisciplinary Center for Biomedical Research and Laboratory, Arubade Medical College Hospital, Vinayagam Research Foundation, Puducherry, Tamil Nadu. Dear colleagues of Madhur Kesari Jain College for Women, dear participants from various parts of India, good morning to all present here. I first thank our management for giving opportunity to conduct this webinar on recent advances in life science. I thank our resource person for accepting our invitation and made his busy schedule. I convey my heartfelt wishes to the head and staff members of Department of Biotechnology and Biochemistry of Madhur Kesari Jain College for Women for their tireless effort for organizing such a wonderful gathering. I hope this webinar gives you all knowledge about recent advances in life science. I convey my best wishes to all the participants. Thank you for watching.
Thank you so much, sir, for your valuable address. It is great happiness to be praised of them who are most praiseworthy. Now, I would like to request Dr. M. Gomati, ma'am, Head Department of Biotechnology, to briefly introduce our chief resource person of the first session, Dr. Prithviraj Nagarajan, sir, Research Scientist, RFRA Medical College and Hospital, Puducherry. Please, ma'am.
A pleasant morning to one and all present here. It gives me immense pleasure introducing our resource person of first session, Dr. Prithviraj Nagarajan, sir. Sir did his master's degree in biotechnology at Annamalai University during 2004-2009. Sir did his master's degree in biotechnology at Annamalai University. Sir completed PG diploma in clinical research and PG diploma in personal management and industrial relations at Annamalai University. He completed his doctorate in marine biotechnology at Annamalai University and MBA in educational management at Kalakappa University, Karaikudi. He completed his postdoctoral fellow in pharmaceutical critical biotechnology at Shanghai Ocean University. Sir served as scientist in pharmaceutical medical biotechnology at Shanghai Jiuquan University, China from 2017 to 2020. He has signed many collaborative projects with Shanghai Jiuquan University, Savita University, Annamalai University, Biozone Research Technologies, Dhanalakshmi Srinivasan Research Institutions, etc. He was awarded with many awards and honors like Best Scientist Award, Best Speech Award, Young Scientist Award, etc. Recently, Sara was awarded with Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Young Scientist Award and Distinguished Fellow Award 2019-20 by Both Science Society for his dedicated service in the field of scientific research and education. He has more than 21 publications in reputed journals and 3 monograph books in Lambert Publication, Germany. Currently, Sir is working as a research scientist, multidisciplinary center for biomedical research lab, Arupadai Medical College and Hospital, Vinayaka Mission Research Foundation, Puducherry. We are happy to have such an eminent personality with us today to share his ideas and natural products in drug discovery. We welcome you once again, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. It's really an honor for us to have you among us, sir. It's time to invite our resource person to kindly take over the session. Please, sir.
Good morning to all. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. I can hear you, sir. Please take over the session, sir.
Yes, sir. Just one second. Can you see my slide? Are you able to see my slide?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So very good morning to everybody. So thank you for your nice introduction. I'm so very happy to join in this webinar, international webinar. So today I'm going to talk about a very important topic: natural products in drug discovery. So this is as a research scientist in Arupadai Field Medical College and Hospital, the Center for Biomedical Research Laboratory. Basically, I am a pharmaceutical biotechnology. I did my master's degree and PhD degree, everything in biotechnology. My area of research is fully focusing on only on natural products and discovery from the natural resources. I did my PhD and I choose my PhD topic on marine resources, especially on starfish and also lionfish and stonefish. I just collected the venom sources from the starfish and also from the stonefishes and see some biological properties and also in vivo and in vitro studies based upon only I'm fully focused on cancer. So now I'm going to tell about what are the natural products which are available in the natural resources for only for drug discovery, especially in diabetes and cancer. And recently now we are focusing the most pandemic situation that is called COVID, right? I mean coronavirus also. I'm saying one information that from the marine sponges, from the Swickman laboratory, now they are focusing on some nanoparticles from the sponges and the resources. This is one of the good information from the natural resources from the marine. So now I'm going to discuss about today the introduction of the drug discovery and how the drug is developed and what are the natural products which are available for the research and also for the research and development for the medicine, and what is the important role of natural products in the drug development and classification of the natural products, and then my conclusion part of this slide, and also I include some of the reference. So my first slide start with the new drugs, how the new drugs discovered from the natural products. So before that, going inside the topic, for example, if you're choosing any natural products from the natural resources, first of all, you should have some pre-knowledge. For example, if you're choosing herbicides or something from any plant resources, hibiscus plant like means, you have to know about some pre-knowledge, some of the information about family, taxonomy, everything. That is very, very important for the research, because basic classification, animal kingdom, phylum is very, very important. Then when all the information is very well known, then we have to collect the source for enough quantity. So for doing the research for natural products, one of the important sources is collecting the source and knowing about the pre-knowledge of the sources. I mean, what the source you are taking from the nature, that is very, very important. When you collect enough quantity of the natural sources, you can go for the crude extract, that is called from the crude extract only you can go for fraction. So first of all, when you go for drug discovery from the crude extract, you have to screen whether the natural products, for example, I'm saying that my hibiscus plant, right? For hibiscus plant, if you just select as a resources as a source for your research, means first you have to screen whether it is having any biological activity or not. How you can screen? You can screen by two methods. One is in vivo and in vitro. This is a basic method you have to follow in our research. So after you are screening your method by in vivo and in vitro, or else you can do some bioassay method. So after they are doing bioassay method, next step is very, very important, separation and purification. So the crude extract contains so many number of lead compounds, so many number of active components, proteins, peptides, amino acids, monopolysaccharides, polysaccharide compounds are there. So first of all, you have to choose which area you have to be focused, whether you have to be go on primary metabolites or secondary metabolites. So I'm saying, for example, if you're focusing on secondary metabolites, you have to go for the crude extract activity by screening in vivo and in vitro. So after, if you have find that such a resources, what you choose having some biological activity, then you can go for purification and separation using column chromatography, for example, ion exchange chromatography. In most of the cases in our laboratory or in the university or in college, we are using ion exchange chromatography and also column chromatography. In some essentially, in cases if you go for good research laboratory or in any university, sir. I mean, the deep universities, now in our laboratory also, they are using HPLC, C18 column SPLC. Through C18 column SPLC, you can separate number of numerous components. So, I mean, I'm saying about active components separately. Then after separating the active components, you can go for library research. For example, MALDI-TAF, Q-TRAP. So by going for the library, you can see whether your active components are having how many amino acid groups, and also which peptide is active, and also what is the molecular weight of the protein or active components. So by base of this library, you can easily know about your compound molecular structure and also your classification of your protein or something else or amino acids. So when you find the good information based on the library, then you can go for finding a lead molecule, whether if you want to go for any bioinformatics, or whether if you want to go for any animal studies to confirm it, or whether if you go for cell line studies. So from some new drug, for example, when you got some new component from the HPLC or from the purification method by using a library from the MALDI-TAF, so you can find a new molecule, that is called new discoveries. Then you can go for clinical trials. And one more thing, that for the clinical trials, it will take for nearly three phases. I mean, phase one, phase two, and phase three. For each phases, it will take nearly so many months or years to confirm your drug. Because you know one, that for in a market, for in a pharmaceutical company, or if you're going for buying any medicines, definitely I can show that when the drug is coming to the market, definitely it will take nearly for 6 or 7 years to confirm. Recently, I can say that the COVID-19 right now, we are struggling to find a new drug, but it is not very easy. We have to first, they say that hydrochloride, then the remdesivir, then so many drugs they already tested, SARS-1 and MERS. Now they are coming the same drugs for the COVID-2. But they didn't have any confirmation, and still we are struggling to find a new drug, right? So this is case. So now we are in clinical trials. So now clinical trials, we are in phase one. Definitely take needed 2 or 3 hours to confirm to have a good clinical drug for the confirmation to cure the COVID diseases. So we are now in clinical phase one. So after the phase two and phase three only, if it is success only, the FDA approval drug organizations, then you will come for the market space. After any new drugs, what are the important steps means? First of all, we have to have some pre-knowledge, and then only we have to collect the resources from the nature. Then you have to go for code extract. Then you should be screened in vivo and in vitro. Based upon you having a good quality result on screen, if you find any good result in screen activity, then you can go for purification and separation. Then we have to check whether the component or a protein or any secondary metabolites which is relevant to the coordinately compared in the library, that which indicate the structure of the compound. Then we have to go for the in silico work to find the lead molecules, then find the new disc, new drug. So these are the basic steps which are you, before you are going for any research, you have to follow. So what natural products? So for drug discovery, why we have choose the natural products means is due to the structural diversity, and apparently it is an unlimited quantity, and also it is evolution against us, and we having in nature, we having more quantity of potency, and also it is safety and efficiency. You know that in India only we having so many natural resources are there. I can say one example, that Nitya Kalyani, right? Nitya Kalyani, that flower, it contains anti-diabetic and also it contains anti-inflammatory activities. But in most cases, we don't know about the biochemical properties and also its properties for any other relevant diseases. But in people, in our Tamil Nadu, thinking means they are just culturally and planting plants in the form as a beauty, right? But we don't know about the natural products. What is the natural biomedical properties of the exact plant? But in China, in South Korea, and in Vietnam, mostly they are cultivating this Nitya Kalyani product plant in agricultural land. They are collecting the plants and they are taking as a tea. I mean, natural tea. And we also taking some green tea, right? But in Vietnam, they are taking this as a tea. And also they are utilizing it as in the medicinal properties as a herbs, Ayurveda herbs, and they are using as a natural product to treat some of the Alzheimer's diseases like this. In our India, we are having so many of the natural diseases, but unfortunately, we are not quantifying, we are not identifying that type of natural diseases for our Indian peoples, whether it is useful or not. So why we are choosing the natural products means, my dear students, in future, definitely those who want to do the research in regarding drug development, my sincere advice is just focus on your nearest plants. We are having all the resources in our hand, in our country. You have to choose which product, how to be dragged, how to drag it, how to be lead the plant to as a drug discovery. That is very important. So why have I choose the natural products is, it is having high potency and it is also very safety and efficiency. One more thing, that in India, if you choose like that, means definitely I can say that there will be no any ethical issues will be there. So if you want to do the research in India, there's no ethical issues, and you can have a drug development from our India, and it should be useful for the society. That's why I'm saying that choosing the natural product from our India, natural resources, is very, very easy, and it is very apparently is unlimited. And also we can quantify it, the crude extract, not the sample for our drug development. So for finding the drugs, I am saying these are very important. So one is identifying the hits, so hits to lead, and third one is a lead optimization. So okay, come to the point of identifying the hits. At this stage, a lot of active components, that is called bioactive components, are tested against the target protein. That is very, very important. most of the active components, compounds or components are tested against the target proteins, and these compounds are showing some chemical activity against that target. For example, when you are focusing for in a cancer or a diabetes, we are choosing some of the natural resources, for example, lithiocalani also, or also some hibiscus plant, and also athimaram, right? Athimaram, and also some of the bamboo. So this kind of the natural plant which are available in our Tamil Nadu, they are specifically focusing on diabetes. So that is a specific target, and it's specific about kids. If you just screen that plant, particular plant of your target with the library means, definitely I can show that from one plant you can able to find nearly 1 lakh compounds or 500 compounds or maybe 250 components. Active components will be there. Some of the known components will be there in a low peak, or just a low protein, low molecular weight. That is also very important. But totally it will result to 100 to 500 hits. If you choose any one active plant or from your natural resources, definitely I can say that you can have some 100 to 500 bioactive components in your one plant. So that is identifying the hits. Then from identifying the hits, from for example from 100 to 500, how to be dragged, come to 1 to 3. Choosing the 10 and come to 5, and from the 5 you go for 1. So that's the steps for finding the rest. For the example, so now I'm going for hits to lead. The hits are the further recognized compounds, that is called leads. Typically 1 to 3 common leads were found. I told that now before, for identifying it in one, definitely 100 to 500 active components. So from go for the purification process or for the library, by the purification process, we can immediately have active component by collecting active pick from the HPLC. For example, 1 or 3 active component found. So from the active component, we go for lead optimization. For example, if we are collecting the active component or active pick from the HPLC purification, then how to choose which pathway? We have to go for a any other tissue healing process in diabetes. As a specific area, specific, I'm saying that. So for lead optimization, it is necessary to optimize the leads properties. Example, toxicity, potency, and also binding strength. So this modification results in 10 to 500 lead variations, which are the preclinical tests. If you find one active component or one drug discovery on bioactive components, definitely you have to test in the lead optimization in the area of bioinformatics or cancer or because we don't know from the plant is very active in any specifications. So definitely you have some preclinical testing. This is how we have to find the drugs. So I can say that is very, very important. I have said in a futuristic form for the research. So okay, sir, if I want to do an MSc, after my MSc, I want to do the research in the drug development as a PhD means, definitely you have to do the research. If you want to find a lead, good discovery compound, definitely you can say that you have to do your PhD for nearly 4 years. Definitely. So in some cases, if you want to find, go for patent, means that will take 3 to 9 years. After finding your lead compound or active components from your PhD research or in some research laboratories, so you have to develop whether this drug molecules are to be used for your human being society. So you have to develop. For the development, it will take nearly 5 to 6 years. Why it will take 5 years means if you find any lead molecule in this laboratory, you have to go for your government and you have to go for your patent. So for the patent, then patent you have to go for some company products, right? So this process development itself will take for 5 to 6 years. Definitely you take. For example, in US and South Korea, they are taking nearly for 4 years. For Indian, I am saying that 5 to 6 years because due to the lack and all availability of source, and they have some clinical trial before the how you did your research methodology. They will ask you a protocol on how your methodology you carry out. So this is under development process. So when the development process is over for the clinical trials, in the company or in pharmaceutical company, you have to tie up with the pharmaceutical company. So they will get your idea and methodology and they will go through the work and whether check whether the product and whether the natural resources having the human or not in the human test in their own laboratory, and it will come for the clinical trials. So in this process, it will take for 3 to 4 years. So after 3 to 4 years only, it will go for next. It will go for approved. It will go for approved progress. So it will take for 1 to 2 years. Definitely, the process will take for 1 to 2 years because all the drugs which are you are in trials for before the process it is approved by the FDA or Food Regulation Government Association also. So it will take nearly for 2 years, and they also drag out your resources and how you carry out the researches, whether it is having any toxicity or it is having any side effects like that. So based upon this only, they will approve your progress, they stay for not. Then only it will come for the marketing. Now, my dear students, just check it out. From that research, what you find a lead molecule or antibody through the marketing, how it will take? For the research, it will take 9 years. Development, 5 to 6 years. For clinical trials, it takes 3 to 4 years. An approval process, 1 to 2 years. So definitely, it will be a product. So that's why that's I'm saying that finding the lead molecules is very, very important. For doing the research, one of the important thing is natural resources availability. Very, very important. The person they will think, I want to do some new idea, I want to develop a new drug. That's also thinking very, very okay. Thinking is good, but for doing the research, one availability, sample collecting, also all you have to collect the sample is very, very important, and process. How you are doing the process also very important, and the clinical trials in vivo and also in vitro studies should have some promising result to show that you are your active compounds are good activity. Based on this only come to the market. So totally, I'm saying that nearly for a good project to be from the world, it will take nearly 10 years. So what are the basic steps? So what are the basic things I just realized in the system course? So from the chemical library, first of all, you have to choose selection of feeds, for example, selection of natural resources. Then you have to find which process is suitable for your resources, whether you are going for the cancer or diabetes. Then you have to screen both in vivo and in vitro tests, and also for the purification. Then you have to choose and also say what active components, what is the status. Found active components can contain polysaccharides, whether it contains amino acid chain. Most of the proteins and most of the components will fully having many attributes. So in this person, I can say that in animal breeding, in veterinary breeding also, I'm saying that most of the animals, they are taking some animal fuel, right? So most of the animal plants which are used in Tamil Nadu, most of the companies are focused. Come for the human. So you have to select the feeds and also find the human ability for that. That's also very important. And you have to do some clinical studies based on animal studies and also cell line studies for cancer. They are most probably we are selecting some cell lines, CF0 cell lines, and also we have some oral cancer cell lines. Like that, so it will be very basic good studies the oral cancer, and also if you have to find based on the single trials, they can find the drug discovery. Then it will come for the development. Why I'm saying that before slide I showed what are how many years it is taking to power for the marketing, but basic steps from the library to the clinical development. One more very important thing is for all this process. The students are researchers. We have to this is very important. One thing about time means for in cases if you are selecting a natural resources from our nature, for example, the plant from our any particular area from in Birupuram or from Maniyapadi means. So the time, I mean, for some plants will have flowering at winter or summer like that. So So you have to choose the time. For testing active components. So basic methods is yes. It's nothing. What is HTSM? High throughput screen. Hello. Can you hear me? Hello. Can you hear me? Yes, sir. Can you hear me? Okay, madam. So screening is a drug process. It is a batch or biochemical activity of drug hormones. What are the assay technology used in HCSMs? Cell group test, and also it's based upon the cell based assays or phenotypic assays. And another is the targeted functional cell based assay. And the other is the enzymatic test, based on fully on biochemical test. So what are the detection methods in this means by using how we can use the detection methods means spectroscopy, mass spectrometry, chromatography, calorimetry, and X-ray diffraction, microscopic and radioactive methods. And what is the specific use of spectroscopic means? In spectroscopy, definitely we can use spectroscopy and ATA, NMR, that is called nuclear magnetic resonance. I'm saying only the important points. And also FTR, the Fourier transfer, we can see only the functional group of compounds are active or proteins by using FTIR. NMR, finally, we can detect the compounds or the proteins. And another is for using the light scattering, by using the light microscopic SMR also, it is very easy to identify the lead components. In chromatographic and heats, what are the chromatographic techniques we are using? Means gas chromatography, thin layer chromatography, and high pressure chromatography, affinity chromatography. In microscopic, what are the hits? We can use, generally, normally we are using tiny microscopic and also atomic force microscopic and also conical force microscopic. So these are the following hits we are using. What are the advantages of first hits? Means it is the speed of high of assay by using microtype plate. Background signals and whether we can easily get the results back, whether it is yes or no. So based on this advantage, research based on the HTS. What are the uses of HTS means? Namely, it is used. Namely, it is used to screen all kinds of normal biological component libraries from products. So must come to the another topic is QSAR. See, QSAR is a mathematical relationship between a biological activity of a molecular system. And it is a geometric and chemical characteristics. The QSAR attempts here to find out the constant relationship between biological activity and molecular properties, so that these rules can be used to evaluate the activity of a new compounds. So in QSAR means definitely it has some biological activity, chemical and other important things. So when it comes to the drug development, so the process of bringing a new drug to the market is called the drug development. Once a lead compound has been identified through the process, it's lead for the drug discovery. So what is drug development means? The process of bringing a new drug to the market. Once a lead compound or an active compound is identified through the process is called a drug discovery. So what are the natural products which means this? We are choosing for plants and animals. So the natural products are the richest source for the biological active components. So this slide shows the what are the natural products for which are available in the as a drugs means. For example, most cases in our life we are using some antibacterial and also antifungal drugs. So for example, insulin, streptomycin, annamycin are the antibacterial. Antibiotics. This can come to the antifungal drugs. Antifungal drugs can come for antitumor drugs. Natural products. So basically, most of the cases for natural products chemistries, we are only from our natural resources. Purification. Compounds obtained with natural or synthetic source, isolated and purified. So for the structural determination, this can be done by various spectral data method by using NMR, IR, and for method for structural determinations, namely we are using NMR and IR and X-ray method. For herbal medicines, we are using the drugs or lead compound that can be isolated from the natural resources. So what is the reason? What is the specific reasons we are using for this one means? Why we are choosing the plant as a natural resources means? Herbal medicines contains a large variety of compounds, different kind of compounds, whether it will be a active component or the protein or any other peptide. So several for several of these means may bring some biological activity, but there is a significant risk of side effects and toxicity in natural products. But in these cases only we are using some purification and characterization method by using HPLCs, because most of the cases some of the natural products of crude extracts may be due to the high dosage it will be a toxic to the human being. But in these cases we have to remove some of the non-toxic substance and also non-active components from the active components. So in these cases, we are using some biological activity to see in vivo and in vitro test by using purification method. So active principle present in the, if the active principle is present, means definitely it will be not much more high, it will be a small amount. So the herbs should be expected to be the expected to be a less active than pure compound. For example, what it says means, Several of these have some moments of biological activity, but it contains also some significant side effects and toxicities. In order to overcome this, we are doing some purification methods. If you do some purification method also, in some cases, the active principle, active components will be a small amount. So expected that it will be less active compounds than the pure compounds. So in the herbal medicines, it will also be interacting with the prescribed medicines. For example, for synthetic medicines also compared with the natural medicines, but there is no regulations or to control this matter and also uses. So for these reasons only we are using the herbal medicines as a drug development. But in these cases, why it is you are using the drug for the plant uses as a drug means because it is contains a low risk of side effects and the toxicity is very, very low. That's a main thing. And also if you are having some components less means from the pure compound, it can easily able to do the same method and also get the more components. That is one of the most important methods for this in the drug development, and it is the main reasons also for you are using the herbal medicines. It is also important to lead to discover the and also design the new drugs from the herbals, because we should not follow the same method. We should not follow taking the same plant as in a different pathway. We have to coordinate also as the same resources from the plant, and also you have to discuss the new, discover and also discover find out the new molecule as a new drugs. So come to the how we are choosing some biosimilars. I told that the screening you have to choose in vivo. So there's two methods, right? So in vivo, non-conventional environment is we are using test tube or culture media, and another was in vivo we are using as a some other method, animal models. That is in vivo. So in ex vivo, usually the first doing the test on the tissue taken from the living organisms or from the humans. So in most cases in abroad and all, we are doing research in vivo and ex vivo, because in in vitro cells we are just doing some microbiology work in the test tube and culture media. But as far as the concern for FDA, they approve only for the animal case studies and also in the human studies. That is, I tell the clinical trials are 2 and 3 cases. So most cases in vivo in you are testing the drugs or in components. Active components will give some better results now. So based on this only, we can do in the clinical trials in the human beings, because I told that in here as a mouse is a human model for the human, no? So mice is a human model. So by testing the your active components or crude extracts or a plant by an animal model, if you have good activity, then doing some other assays, enzymatic assays and clinical assays and cell line assays, then find out for the human trial. So this are the balance when the drug when come to the market, they have to be work have to be done and you have to work through on it. So in vivo studies, what are the problems? Means it is first of all things, it is more expensive. In many cases, it may cause suffering to the animals, and the results may be clouded by interference with other biological activity. For example, I told that in any for the choosing in the animal models, definitely the time and money is very, very important, and it is more expensive. It is also causes suffering to the animals, because for doing animal activity, they will ask how many animals you are choosing, how you are going to treat the animals, how you are going to give the component to the animals. These are the what are the how you will sacrifice the animals. So this in the cases we are facing some. That results may be interference with other biological activity. For example, for focusing on some neurological problem means definitely it shows some source some other activities or in mice also. It is also one of the tragedy in doing animal studies. In most cases in UK, use nearly 2 million of animals are used in a clinical trials for doing the research. In India also we are using nearly. For what animals we are using all over the India, but in most of the cases in UK and China, they use nearly 2.6 million more animals. In China and all, they are using teddy bear and also they are using animal mouse, and most of them they are using rabbit also. They are using now for the neurological disorder. This is also they are using. So this is one of the important things. What a tragedy we are facing in the animal studies. So how to develop the next products and how it can be classified into means. What are the sources means? We are taking the sources from plant, animal, microbial, and marine, and also from venom and toxins. So let's see one by one. So now I'm going to talk about the plant sources. The most of the biological active components are from the plant secondary metabolites with the complex structures. And plants are considered as one of the richest source of the lead compounds. Examples: morphine. I can say that Aditya Kalyani, then we are having some terminal muruganam, also some weapon neem tree. They all are having some biological activities. For animal sources, next time I'm talking about animal sources. Animals are sometimes be a source of the new biological active compounds. For example, I can say some antibiotic peptides are extracted from the frog. African frog, they extract some antibiotic peptides. Most recently, now I have know the T-exon peptide and also C-fos peptide. So this kind of the peptides are recently identified from the African frog skin layer. I mean, I will have a good potent anesthetic compound, and this is obtained from the skin extract of the African frog. So, and it is a poison frog. You can ask one question: if I guess having like that activity means they having some activity, but the most of us the poison. No, I can say one word that the sea creatures or any other animal creatures in the plant or animal and in a forest, those who are colorful are attractive. It definitely will contain some toxic and venom components in the body. It's a scientific approach. I'm saying that. So this is African. This figure shows the African. This is African. It has some toxins, and it is secreted from the skin secretions of the frog. Today, the major research tool is developed by Analysis. They are using the some of the active compounds from this frog, and it plays a promising drug story. So I am saying only for example. In most cases, also in some other animals also we are using. We are seeing so much of animals saliva like the thing is there. So to the microorganisms. The microorganisms is another potent source of the lead drugs. And the classical example is that penicillin. We all know that penicillin is discovered by the Alexander Fleming. Come to the marine resources. As I am a marine resources person, I can talk about more about marine resources. In recent researches, there have been a great interest in finding out the pharmacological active substances from the marine resources. For example, coral, sponges, fish, and marine organisms have a wealth of biologically potent chemicals with interesting the anti-inflammatory and anti-cancer activity. For example, curacin A is obtained from the marine cyanobacterium, and it shows a potent antimicrobial activity. And another antimicrobial actions are from like bromocyanin, zoledronic, and cyproconazole are also found in the marine resources. We can see very more about this one. This all called a very beautiful creatures, conus. Conus lines will having some having so much of variety out there. Maybe corals, mollusk is there, physical variety is there. But so most of the conus are fish hunters and mollusk hunters. We are talking about only the biomedical properties. No, so I can say that xenocycline drug is obtained from the conus, and it is called conus toxins. It is having blocking the ion channels, allowed to use the drugs to treat as a various neuro problems. They are using these drugs in market also. We are having the xenocycline drugs from the conus. So marine is one of the good research. So resources for the identifying the many biological substances from the nature. And one more than that, it is 1,000 times more potent than the marine, and it is not active. That is very, very important. From the drug which are identified from the marine resources of conus and xenotac, there's ever tested to block the chronic pain in the patients with the terminal as cancer and also in AIDS. And moreover, it is in a powder form, and it is effectiveness, and it is higher than the other related drugs. I can say that the xenotoxin now is also used as a painkiller for the anesthetic drug. Those who are going for the spinal cord injury, you know, they are giving this drug as a painkiller. So this is bioinformatics information regarding the conus. This is called conotoxins or conopeptides. So you can see that most conopeptides are ranged from 10 to contain amino acids and plus. Each cone species contain various numerous unique peptides. So for the peptides and proteins are also very, very important for the active components. And it's currently estimated that nearly 50,000 different monopeptides, which are less than 0.1% have been characterized to date. And moreover, that in Annamalai University in marine biology department now, still the research is going on conopeptides and also sea anemone, which contain like this conotoxins. This is very, very important for the drug discovery. And they have been the project natural from the drug discovery. Also, they have as a project from the DBT. So from the pharmaceutical drugs, what are the actual uses? Mean we are using some soft tissue carcinoma, which is from the sponges, and from the corners we are using chronic pain anesthetic drug. From the sponges we are having breast cancer drug. From the other sponge we are having a treatment of leukemia disease RIA and RSC, and also the another one more thing, fish oil, no? Omega fatty acids from all the fish liver, from the all the fish. So, the fish liver oil, we are eating the omega-3 fatty acids as a protein concentration, for the protein efficiency and also protein concentration is low. So, come to the methods, mainly what are the supplements we are eating means seaweed. For the seaweed is good active for the anti-diabetic, anti-obesity, antioxidant and anti-cancer. And for you are eating the prawn, right, which are rich in 3 omega fatty acids, vitamin A and vitamin E. We are having so much of number of flavonoids, which are used for anti-inflammatory, antioxidant, and also cardioprotective activity. When you come talk about the marine algae, we are having antioxidant and anti-tumors. So these are the biological properties are natural resources. So obtained from the marine, having so much of biological properties in the human and also in the clinical trials. One of the important thing is marine collagen, which contains low molecular peptides, which is derived from the skin of salmon. We are eating daily or weekly from the fish, from the sea. We are eating so much of fish now, which contains marine collagen, good for the anti-diabetic, and it's used for the antioxidants, reduce the hypertension, and anti-skin aging, anti-ulcer, and finally it improves our lipid metabolisms. What are the other resources of animals? I can say about spider. It's one of the most powerful in the world, but it is very toxic. In our home, we are seeing some spider, no, that is not toxic. But most cases in the forest area, we are seeing some spider, which is very, very toxic. And from the toxic, they are taking some medical component, especially for cardiac arrest and cerebral problems. What is the name of the toxin? Is PHKV toxin is one of the component which obtained from the spider, from the forest of the, from the forest like the Andaman forest, and also from the our Indian forest in Kerala also, we are there seeing some of the spiders having some active components. So what are the main components is PHKV1 and TX34. These are the toxins that are replaced from these animals. And it is very, very important that they are mainly used for cerebral stroke and also cerebral infections, and used to treat the cardiac disorders. And this all we all know that scorpion, right? We are seeing the scorpion. Definitely in all the persons, they can see the scorpions. So the scorpions are blue scorpion, red scorpions. It's an endemic species. And the venom contains so many peptides and all the biotic components able to treat as anti-algic and also anti-cancer treatments. Mainly they have do the more research in the island of Cuba and also in the river, and also in the East, in the Eastern and European countries they are doing this kind of research. And also another one near such a Puran, right? And it is called yellow leg semiconductor. It's one of the gigantic organisms having later have an active component and more venom. So the venom contains more active peptides and be used for the anti-cancer and also anti-diabetic properties. So what is the tragedy? What we are facing means what? How the research now for the from nature to drug means? I'm saying in pharmacology approach, first from the human, from the animal, they are testing the some of the active components, functional active growth, even in vitro, by extracting the drugs. I mean the active crude drugs from the nature, and from the testing to the animal and on the man, then they go find the lead components and finding the target activation. This is a forward methodology what we use now. We can see that oppositely, we can see the opposite reverse pharmacology method is, so from here, just designing the active molecule, finding the active nearly molecule by using in silico works, and and utilizing in the animal studies and identifying the promising target proteins and screening for the components interact with the target proteins from this in silico work towards the animal work, giving the active compound towards the animal, then killing the animal and extracting the tissues, then finding the active protein and screening the compounds, then again come to the in vivo using animal and also by informatics to the animal, like that forward to reverse. This is the new methodology we are now focusing, and most of the European countries also following that reverse pharmacology method. Because why I am saying that pharmacology method they are not following means cost and effective and sample resistance is very low. So what they are doing means from the selection of library they are selecting the lead molecules or lead compounds, that they are designing the in silico works, then the ordering the peptide or the sequence or any other component from the company, and they are seeing the activity in the animal. That through the some microbiology work, they identify the target proteins through some microorganism or through the animal or through the man, then come to the drug discovery. This is a reverse pharmacology method, most probably they are using in China and South Korea also. So what are the untarget metabolic workflows means? For example, experiment design is one of the more important. First of all, when you are doing some research means the designing of work is very important. The next one is a sample preparation. I told you that no, so for sample preparation, then you have to have some pre-knowledge, and then from the food extract you have to do for purification method. On purification experience, you go for NMR or MS, I mean MALT data. From there, they are going for pre-analyzing data using the metabolic identification. For example, NMR and MS, I mean MALT data can give the single peak. Also, they can give the single molecular peptide, molecular compound. And they can also target this compound is where it is metabolically matched with the other organisms. And also you can say some phylogenetic analysis also. If you are taking some plant also, your active compound is well matched with this kind of animal, this kind of toxin. For example, I am taking any plant from the natural resources means, if I am taking omega-3, for example, I am saying omega-3 means, if omega-3 is more, it is very active means, it was mismatch, it was matched with the library, and you say that this omega fatty acid is 89 is matched with the musket research. I mean this animal, for spider animal or some toxic animal like a frog skin, like that it is so. So this is untarget metabolic workflow means from the unknown we have to see through the known person using the musket research or NMR such as that is called in silico studies. So I come to the conclusion. The natural products and the derivatives have historically been available as a source of therapeutic agents. And one more than that, for most cases in the past decade, the research into the natural products in the pharmaceutical industries has declined. And it is also having some issues such as lack of complementarity of a traditional natural product, except from the libraries, with high throughput screening. And the recent technology advances that help to address these issues, coupled with unrealized expectation from current generation strategies, and have to lead to a renewed interest in natural product in drug discovery. So, in these cases, the various screening approaches have been developed to improve the cases in which natural products can be used in the drug discovery as a champions. And also data mining and virtual screening techniques are being applied to the database of natural products. It is hoped that most efficient and effective application of natural products will improve the drug discovery process. So this diagram shows that the world map now. So bioactive ingredients in the growth rate all over the global. So the green indicates the growth rate, recent growth rate, they're using so much of natural products in these countries. Mild, we are belong to the mild, right? We are belong to the mild. So in India also, in other, in the globe, it just shows the mild now. They are having the using, utilizing the our natural resources only mildly. But you can see in America and use everything, you know, they're using much more natural products. And also they're going for the Siddha and Ayurveda, biochemical, bio nature products as a drug discovery. In most cases, for the COVID also, now the US are giving a lot of money for the researchers only focusing on natural products. In India also recently, so some of the issues are going there. They find some new drug for the COVID. from the natural resources, now the kill pressure in the US. So finally, I can say that it's not a end of era, but it is an endless fortuner to find the direct development from the natural resources. Once again, I'm saying that it is not an end of an era, but it is endless of fortuner for finding the natural resources from the nature. So these are the following references I have taken for our webinar. So the persons you want to be get more information, you can get, you can go to these references. So finally, I can say that our beloved honorable Abdul Kalam, our my favorite president, they have said that without your involvement, you can't able to succeed, but with your involvement, you can't able to find. Once again, I say that without your involvement in your research, you cannot able to succeed, but with your involvement in your research and your career, definitely you can't able to find. So I wish you all the students, those who want to do the research, that focusing on your involvement, good research and good outcome in your future. Thank you. Thank you. Any questions?
Hello.
Any questions? Hello.
Hello. Hello. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your wonderful presentation, sir.
Yeah.
So actually, there is some technical issues, sir. So
yeah, yeah.
Session will start.
Some technical issues.
Yes, actually, we are not able to go live, sir, in YouTube. There are many participants who are interested to join in YouTube, sir. So the second session will start after 10 minutes, sir.
Okay,
I'm requesting the participants as well to kindly rejoin after 10 minutes, sir. So they can post their queries at the end of the second session, sir.
No problem, madam. No problem. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I request all the participants to rejoin after 10 minutes. The second session will start in 10 minutes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes,
Yeah.